Ladies and gentlemen, you are here. That means you are as excited as me to use Siri shortcuts on your Mac. It is going to be insane. So what are we waiting for? Let's dive in, shall we? Okay, let's talk about the interface first. It's almost as using the Shortcuts app on your iOS devices. Every shortcut I have on my iPhone are synced on my Mac as well. Although I'll be talking about their compatibility with macOS later in this video. Coming back to the interface, you can hide the sidebar to give it a more iOS-like touch. Or, if you want it to be different on your Mac, simply change the view to list and boom. This might be better for some folks, but I definitely prefer the gallery view. Now, Shortcuts is not much of use if you don't have actual shortcuts that work on Macs, right? So we do have some basic and weird shortcuts available here in the gallery tab. It's divided into sections, that's nice. You could start with the starter shortcuts, but let's try share sheet shortcuts for this video. You'll see a tick instead of a plus sign if you already have that shortcut. Moving on to adding a shortcut of your choice, click on the shortcut and add it from here. Now you'll have some details about the shortcut and where it is supported. Like this one is only for share sheet on iOS, so it's not much of use on Macs. But if you take another shortcut, for example tweet selected code, you can see the shortcut is available in service menu also. So let's add the shortcut quickly. Shortcut added. So if we select something to tweet, right click or double tap and from services at the bottom, here is our just added shortcut. Give permission as for once or always. This is just an example for a service menu Siri shortcut. I don't actually think this shortcut worked. Service menu was just the tip of the iceberg. We have got specific tabs for menu bar and quick actions in the sidebar. Now, whether a shortcut supports being in quick actions or not, you can still add as many shortcuts as you want in quick actions or menu bar. And it's as simple as drag and drop. Menu bar added shortcuts will be just a click away from activation. And for quick action shortcuts, select a file in Finder, then from Finder in the menu bar and services here, we have all our added shortcuts for quick actions. Also, I thought we could add shortcuts to dock for faster access, but I'm not able to add. If anyone knows how to do let me know in the comments below. Also, like and subscribe for more videos. Now, editing the icon and color is much simpler on macOS. You can double click on the shortcut and edit, or if you want to edit the icon, simply right click, select edit color, choose a new icon and color, and voila. The beauty about shortcuts on a Mac is now you can use some keyboard shortcuts like Command plus R to run a shortcut or Command plus N to make a new shortcut, and lots of shortcuts while making a new shortcut. I'll be talking about that in a minute. One more global keyboard shortcut is Command plus comma for shortcuts preferences. Now if you don't want all your iPhone shortcuts to be synced in your Mac and vice versa, this could be a mess on your iPhone or on your Mac, because most of them won't work on the Mac. So simply deselect iCloud sync here. This should stop the syncing. Coming to compatibility, there are some third-party shortcuts which are working like a charm on my Mac, like this Shazam to Spotify for example. It's almost working as perfectly it works on my iPhone. So I'd say shortcuts on Mac is going to open a lot of doors for us for sure. I will be making dedicated videos for new shortcuts, so stay tuned for that. You can also make your own custom shortcuts if you want. Select from a range of all these actions or select actions categorized by apps. But I'm not going to show how to make one in this video. But if you do want to start making your own Siri shortcuts, hit that notification button so you get notified when I do post those videos. Automation was already a part of macOS long before Shortcuts was introduced. It's a whole other app on a Mac. You can find it in utilities called Automator. shortcuts have become a super useful addition to use with Automator. These are some of my automations I have created. There are a lot of possibilities with shortcuts and automations on macOS, which can seriously make our lives more productive and our workflow more efficient. For including those possibilities in your life, I highly recommend you subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. My name is Mufaddal. This is Apple Vibes. Take care, and I will see you in the next video.